Vayechi. I'd like to say a few words about one of the important early figures of early modern Zionism. And then you will soon learn its connection to Parashat Vayechi. After Theodor Herzl died, in the very, very beginning of the 20th century, untimely in his death, a very young man, comparatively speaking, the one who took over the world Zionist leadership was an individual named Max Nordau. Max Nordau was not only not a religious man, religiously observant, neither was Theodor Herzl. But Max Nordau had very little connection with Jewishness. Indeed, he was married to a Christian woman. And he was very far removed from the Jewish community. He was a very successful physician, diagnostician, the best of the diagnosticians in Vienna. He had a very wealthy clientele. But no prior relationship to Judaism or Zionism. But almost suddenly became a committed Zionist and took over the movement, Max Nordau. In his diary appears the following story. There were Hasidic Jews, generally poor, who lived in Vienna. And Max Nordau writes in his diary he had no contact with them. They were not his clients, his patients. His patients were much wealthier. A Hasidic man and woman came into his office with a 10-year-old girl who couldn't even walk by herself. They cried before the secretary. That only a few weeks before she was dancing and singing and jumping all around the streets. And now she was struck by this malaise that couldn't be diagnosed. Max Nordau came out of his inner office, saw the situation, looked at the young girl, felt that he might be able to find a solution to the problem, and did. 2 years later, the parents returned with a smiling, happy, skipping young woman. The parents went into the office of Dr. Nordau, kissed his hands in thanksgiving, and they said they want a bill because they want to pay. They won't be able to pay it once. It'll take them a very long time. But he gave them back their daughter. God, but he was the agent of God. Max Nordau writes that he smiled. He realized they had no money at all. And he said, I'll tell you what I would like for my payment. Let this very lovely young woman give me a kiss on the cheek. The girl turned crimson red. I've just become bat mitzvah, age 12, she said. I go to a Beth Jacob seminary. I cannot kiss a strange adult, male. Max Nordau said, then tell me something you studied at your religious school this morning. And she had just studied the portion wherein Father Jacob blesses his grandchildren. And he speaks about his peregrinations. Chapter 48, verse 7, and I, when I came from Padan Aram, my beloved Rachel died in the land of Canaan, only a short distance from Efrat. And I buried her there, on the road to Efrat, in Bethlehem. The young girl says, Rashi asks the obvious question, why didn't he go to Hebron, where all the other patriarchs and matriarchs were buried? And the answer, from Jeremiah chapter 31, that when the Jews will be carted off to exile, they'll pass by Rachel's grave. And the spirit of Rachel will cry out to God, I was compassionate towards my sister, she will say, who was substituted for me under the nuptial canopy. Please, God, show this compassion to your children. Don't let them die in exile. And God responds, Vishavu vanim ligvulam. There is a reward for your actions. Your children will return to their boundaries. They'll come back to Israel. And Max Nordau writes that this young girl said it with tremendous conviction. And he asked her, do you really believe after close to 2,000 years of exile, there's a chance you're going to go back to Israel? And she put her hand on her heart and she said, with all my heart, the Bible promises. That moment changed my life, he writes. If young Jewish children can believe in their return to Israel, in God's guarantee, then it will happen. Then I believe in it too. And that was the beginning of my odyssey in Zionism. And my beloved watchers and listeners, Efrat in this story likewise brought me into very profound and heartfelt Zionism. Shabbat Shalom.